Today, we're going to look at a BodyViz brain builder about the inner ear and Ménière's disease. The ear is a complex organ that provides sensory input for hearing and balance. It is divided into three segments: the external ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. In this brain builder, we're going to look at the anatomy of the inner ear. The inner ear contains sensory receptors for hearing and equilibrium. It consists of a series of interconnected, fluid-filled sacs and ducts. These sacs and ducts are suspended within a bony labyrinth of the temporal bone. The bony labyrinth is composed of the cochlea, vestibule, and three semicircular canals. The cochlea translates mechanical vibration of sound into nerve impulses. The vestibule has two parts, the utricle and saccule, that are involved in equilibrium. The semicircular canals contain receptors that respond to angular acceleration. The bony labyrinth is lined by a serose membrane that secretes a fluid termed perilymph. Inside of the bony labyrinth is a membrane-lined canal called the membranous labyrinth that contains a fluid called endolymph. Although a definitive cause of Ménière's disease is unknown, an increase in endolymph and or perilymph volume within the inner ear may be the cause. Ménière's disease typically affects individuals between the ages of 40 and 60 years old. Next, we look at the symptoms, causes, and treatments for Ménière's disease, and finally, give a patient example. Symptoms of Ménière's disease includes dizziness, vertigo, hearing loss, sensation of fullness within the affected ear, and tinnitus, which is a ringing, buzzing, or roaring sound within the ear. As mentioned, the definitive cause for Ménière's disease is unknown, but an increase in endolymph and or perilymph volume within the inner ear may be the cause. The increased fluid levels may be due to high blood pressure, allergies, autoimmune disorders, and or the reduction of fluid reabsorption. There is no cure for Ménière's disease. However, symptoms may be reduced in severity and frequency through intratympanic injection of medication intended to reduce dizziness, anti-vertigo medication to reduce or stop acute episodes of Ménière's disease, a low-salt diet, prescription of diuretics to reduce blood pressure and hopefully decrease the secretion of endolymph and perilymph within the ear. And lastly, surgery. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age, 28. Sex, male. Chief complaints, dizziness, and head pressure. You invite the patient into your office for an examination. You ask your patient when they first started feeling dizzy. Your patient explains that they woke up this morning feeling a bit dizzy, and when they were riding their scooter to work, they found it very hard to balance and the movement made them feel nauseous. You identify the dizziness your patient is experiencing as vertigo and examine their ears. Your patient is also experiencing head congestion from seasonal allergies, which is causing the head pressure and making their left ear feel very full. You perform a hearing test and your patient's hearing is below normal in their left ear. You diagnose your patient with Ménière's disease and talk to them about ways to minimize the symptoms they are experiencing. You prescribe anti-vertigo medication and a diuretic to hopefully reduce the production of endo and perilymph in their left ear. This is a classic example of Ménière's disease. Thank you for watching this Brain Builder video. Please like and subscribe to our BodyViz channel. Or if you're new at BodyViz, check out our other anatomy resources and schedule a demo at bodyviz.com.